airlines are perceived differently by different people in different countries, okay? Fortunately, maybe unfortunately, airlines or an aircraft in India is still considered as an object of luxury, object of aspiration, okay? It is not like that in developed countries, okay? So innovation will not is not something where you make this particular object much more sexier, okay? In fact, you should make it far more accessible, okay? A person in a smaller town, in a smaller village, with a decent living, should not think twice that he has to catch an aircraft. It should not be an aspiration for that particular person to come and think that, hey, can I afford a ride on an aircraft? Their focus of innovation should be, innovation's focus should not be, hey, can I make this aircraft far more sexier? Can I make this airport far more sexier? I don't want that. That's not what I'm looking at, okay? I want cost of technology through innovation to come dramatically down in airlines. Get away from these specialized systems. Use a lot of commodity technology. Now, if you look at Vistara, if you look at infrastructure of Vistara, Vistara's infrastructure is on cloud. Arguably, only airline in the world whose 100% infrastructure is on cloud. Right? Why can't others do that? Because when your infrastructure is on cloud, one is that you get this whole, you know, economics of scale. Plus, as you grow, you can actually grow your infrastructure. Your computational power is not an obstacle anymore. So you can build things, you know, you can increase your computational power during seasonal sales, and you can reduce it, okay? Again, the point which I'm trying to make is a lot of, what is cloud? Cloud is a commodity technology, right? Why can't other commodity technologies come and solve problems of reservations? Solve problems of network, solve problems of connectivity. Now, I understand, you know, there is a little bit of romance in my voice. There is a little bit of, you know, technologist romance, because then there is a regulatory agencies, then there are legacy system, then there are, there are systems which have been proven again and again. And airline literally work on fault tolerant systems. But you know, someday somebody has to make a start. Large companies who supply technology to airlines are trying to change themselves, but you know, they are gorillas, and it's very difficult for a gorilla to get up and, you know, dance, right? It's very difficult, and when gorillas dance, then the whole ecosystem is shaken up, right? So why can't, you know, these startups can really, really see a lot of opportunities within airline to do that, right? Take a scenario, a very simple scenario. A lot of people talk about IoT and sensors and all this stuff. How much of that part of tech we actually use in this whole ecosystem? Don't alienate airline. Take government machinery, take security agencies, take regulatory bodies, take airport, take aircrafts. If you take whole system altogether, okay, don't you think, you know, it would be interesting that anyone who is approaching, you know, airport knows where to go?